Now we want to see the laws of static friction. Laws of static friction. See that, what is the first statement? The statement is that the force, the limiting force of static friction, limiting force of static friction, static friction is directly proportional to normal reaction, is directly proportional to normal reaction, normal reaction. So we can say that Fs is directly proportional to m. When the two bodies in contact, the limiting force of static friction is directly proportional to the normal reaction. Then we write as Fs is directly proportional to m. Fs is the static force of static friction, n is the normal reaction. It can be written as Fs is equal to mu s into n. Again we know that mu s is the constant of proportionality. Constant of proportionality. And this mu s can be written as mu s is equal to Fs divided by n. So the coefficient, it is the mu s is known as the coefficient of static friction. Coefficient of static friction. We can define the coefficient of static friction is that the ratio of force of static friction to the normal is called as the coefficient of static friction. We can verify the law by the experiment. आपण हा लॉ जो आहे तो एका एक्सपेरिमेंट वरून त्याला व्हेरीफाय करू शकतो. कसं करता येईल आपल्याला? सो अगेन वी सी दॅट द कंडिशन वी कॅन आय कॅन ड्रॉ द ग्राफ आय कॅन ड्रॉ द डायग्राम. हियर इज द टेबल टॉप अँड ए बॉक्स इज अटॅच ऑर द बॉक्स इज केप्ट ऑन इट. When this box is the thread which connected to this box is now moving on the pulley, it is going on the pulley and a pan is attached to it. When you apply the force on this applied force, F is created. On this block there are two forces acting on it. In equilibrium condition, one is the weight, you know that it is equal to mg, and the second force acting on it is the normal reaction. These two forces acting on the blocks. When you adding the pan on it and the box tends to move, you can find that the force of friction is F1 in here. We say that it is F1 in here. Note down this reading. This weight is W. We say that the force F is acting on it, and according to this, we can note down this reading. F1 is the force of static friction. It is equal to the applied force, and the weight, it is equal to normal reaction. We can note it this. In the second condition, now a two box are kept on each other having the same weight, or we can increasing the weight in here. Again, this is the same figure I can draw in here. The pan is attached to it. So this is the normal reaction. Now here is the normal reaction N1. So normal reaction is N2, and weight is W2 is here. Note down the normal weight in here. So we can apply the force again in here, and suppose that force F2 is there. By applying this body or the block just to move, then note down the frictional force, what is just to move, suppose that the normal reaction or the force is F2. Now down the F2 is the force, we can find that F1 divided by N is equal to F2 divided by N is equal to constant. And thus this is the verification of first law, that is the law of static friction. This is the verification. If it is the constant, it is equal to the coefficient of static friction. So this is the verification. I can repeat it. For the first time, we can only one block is kept there. So W is the, there is a two forces which is acting on it. First is the weight, second is the normal reaction. When you apply the force in the pan, the body or the block just to move, the applied force is F1, therefore the force of static friction is F1. And after that, you can put a two blocks like as this, or a weight is applied on it, and then the normal reaction is N2, weight is W2, and the force F2 is acting on it. So you can note that the frictional force is F2, and we find that F1 divided by N is equal to F2 divided by N is equal to constant. And this is the verification of this law, first law. Now, we want to see the second law. The second law is that this limiting force of friction is independent on apparent area of body. See the statement again. We stated that the limiting force of friction is independent on apparent area of the body. Again, we can verify this law. I draw the figure for it. So, first a block like as this, the two blocks are kept on each other. This is a tabletop. A pulley for a tabletop is like as this. It is bind to a thread and a pan is suspended to it. Again, the two forces acting on it. First is that is the weight for it. Suppose that weight is W. W is the weight in here. And second is that this is the normal reaction. For a first block, it is the normal reaction is M1. And for the second block, it is M2. So then this is the figure for us. And when the block is attached to it, the applied force is, suppose that F1 is here, we find that the frictional force is again F1. So now the second condition is that, or next condition, the normal reaction is the same in here. This is the first block, this is the second block, which is kept one after another. It is the first block. So we say that the normal reaction is acting on this is N1. Normal reaction is acting on the second is N2. The weight is W. And the force is applied to it by using the pan in here. The pan lavalela ahe. And force upon applied to it. When the force is applied on this, suppose that the force is F2, we can note it in here. The static friction, the force of static friction is F2. We can find that F1 is equal to F2. F1 is equal to F2. And because of this and म्हणून याच्यामुळे limiting force of friction is independent on the apparent area when the normal reaction is not changes. Remember that in this condition normal reaction is not changes. आपल्याला लक्ष ठेवायला पाहिजे इथे normal reaction ही बदललेली नाही. Then the third is that तिसरा आहे आपल्याला की लिमिटिंग फोर्स ऑफ फ्रिक्शन हा जो लिमिटिंग फोर्स ऑफ फ्रिक्शन आहे फोर्स ऑफ फ्रिक्शन इज डिपेंड अपॉन लिमिटिंग फोर्स ऑफ स्टैटिक फ्रिक्शन लिमिटिंग फोर्स ऑफ स्टैटिक फ्रिक्शन इज डिपेंड अपॉन नेचर एंड मटेरियल nature and material of the substances. Again we can verify this law that is the limiting force of static friction is depend upon nature and the material. So for it we consider that again a block which is kept on the tabletop, when it is smooth, one is rough. So again, I can draw the figure. This is the tabletop, and first we take in this tabletop is a rough, and we can if it is the rough, we can again note the force of friction is F1. Again, the second condition is kept. This block is kept on the smooth, and therefore the force of friction is F2. Force of static friction is F2. Here we can find that F1 is not equal to F2. It means that limiting force of friction is depend upon the nature. Nature वर ते depend आहे असं आपण त्याला सांगतो आहोत. And the third is that again it is depend upon the material. So if you kept a block of one material which is kept on a table top and you note again the force of static friction which is acting on it is F1, kept at another block which is having a different material than the first and no doubt this force of static friction is F2, so we can find that F1 is not equal to F2. Thus we can see that the limiting force of friction is depend upon the nature and the